If you are having pain in your clitoris, penis, scrotum, labia, perineum, or anus, especially when sitting, your doctors have ruled out infections and they're not sure what's wrong with you, you might have pudendal neuralgia. In this video, we are going to talk about what pudendal neuralgia is, how people get it, and why physical therapy is such an important part of someone's treatment plan to help recover from this syndrome. If you suspect you have pudendal neuralgia, one of the questions you need to ask is it on one side of my body or both? We have a pudendal nerve on the right, we have a pudendal nerve on the left, and commonly when it starts to get activated and turns into a neuralgia, it's going to affect one side more than the other. It's important to differentiate neuralgia symptoms from muscle aches and pains. And so typically neuralgias, whether it's pudendal or elsewhere, have sharp, shooting, stabbing pain. Versus, I feel a little achy, I feel a little sore, that's different. We're really looking along the path of the nerve to see that it's neuropathic in nature. And by neuropathic, we mean burning, throbbing, aching, stabbing. The pudendal nerve is unique because it is one of the only peripheral nerves in the body that has sensory fibers, motor fibers, and autonomic, which means automatic, fibers too. In addition to the pain that accompanies pudendal neuralgia, the pudendal nerve is involved in a number of reflexes that are tied to orgasm, bowel movements, and urinary function. So people may also experience urinary urgency frequency, burning with urination, painful ejaculation, inability to orgasm, or difficulty with bowel movements and pain associated with bowel movements. There's a wide range of reasons why people develop pudendal neuralgia, and for some people, it can be one of the things I'm about to mention or a combination of a few. So if we're looking at some of the general categories, we can start with compression. This means the people who are cyclists, who ride horses, or who sit for long periods of time during the day. Going in the opposite direction, there can also be tension injuries. So this is more commonly associated with things like long second stages of labor or chronic constipation or certain types of exercise that involve deep and excessive ranges of motion with the hip and lumbar spine. The next category can be associated with surgical trauma. So for various pelvic floor conditions, whether it's prostatectomy or pelvic floor reconstruction for different types of prolapse, there can be a surgical insult somewhere along the path of the pudendal nerve. And finally, there can be traumatic issues that affect the pudendal nerve, such as car accidents or falling on top of various items in your lawn or in the yard that can basically cause an injury in or around the pudendal nerve space. Because there are so many different reasons why somebody has pudendal neuralgia, it's really important to get down to their anatomy and physiology to figure out what is causing their symptoms. So regardless of the mechanism of how it developed, the next phase is to figure out, is there muscle dysfunction? Is there tissue dysfunction? What is happening along the course of someone's pudendal nerve that does not allow the nerve to move, glide, and slide the way it should, therefore resulting in symptoms? So unfortunately, the people you think to go to when you have symptoms of pudendal neuralgia, a gynecologist, a urologist, potentially a neurologist, are really not the people equipped to evaluate why someone has pudendal neuralgia, which really leads into the expertise of a pelvic floor physical therapist and physical therapists who can identify various muscles, tissues, and reasons why the nerve is compromised. So physical therapy is so important for pudendal neuralgia, because what will happen during the evaluation with a physical therapist compared to a swab or a culture or something that happens on the medical side is the physical therapist is going to do a history to help identify potential mechanisms as to why their nerve got irritated, but then also do a very specific physical exam that is going to look at movement patterns, muscle tone in the pelvic floor and the pelvic girdle muscles, trigger points, tissue issues, and reasons that are going to compromise the nerve anywhere along its course, which runs basically from the sacrum through the pelvic floor to all the different areas we mentioned initially, the clitoris, the penis, the scrotum, the labia, the perineum, and the anus. There are various places along the course of the nerve that can get compromised. Certain people may have compromise along the entire track of the nerve. Certain people may only have compromise in one little spot. The physical exam and the movement exam that physical therapists can do will help identify each individual person's causes for why they're having the symptoms that they're having.